Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn about overtone bands, combination bands, difference bands, and Fermi resonance. So these are the target for this video. We are going to see one by one. Yes. Apart from fundamental absorption, for IR spectra, due to the excitation from ground state to the lowest energy excited state, the spectrum is usually complicated by the presence of weak overtone, combination bands, and different bands. So whenever we are taking IR spectra, the absorption band should show simplified graph. But in place of that, we are getting little bit complicated graph, which is unexpected, right? So why it is unexpected? Because the ground state to lowest excited state transitions, excitations, shows some specific type of bands like overtone, combination, and difference. These are making the graph little bit complicated. So we should simplify it. How we can simplify? We have to understand every of this one by one. Yes. First, we have to see overtone bands. So what are overtone bands? When excitation from ground state to higher energy state, means if molecule is absorbing energy, it will definitely go to the higher energy state, which corresponds to integral multiples of frequency of the fundamental. See, here we define the fundamental frequency as nu. Fundamental frequency is defined as nu. And if the excitation from ground to higher state is in integral of multiples, multiples means what? If the fundamental is nu, then the combination will be 2 nu, 3 nu, etc. Up to etc. Means in multiples, right? So weak overtone bands will be observed at 2 nu, 3 nu, 4 nu, etc. So this is the combination, overtone band. So overtone band means what? You are getting some integral multiple frequencies in your spectra. It means overtone. Suppose if we have a ketone group and we are supposing that it is coming 1700 centimeter inverse. So the overtone band may be appear as 3400, means two time of that. So that is 2 nu. So that is about overtone band. Now next, combination band. Suppose we have a fundamental frequency nu. So if fundamental frequency is nu, so two different frequency which are fundamental, we can tell is nu1 and nu2. Nu1 and nu2. Why we are calling nu1 and nu2? Because we want to define some names. One suppose X and another suppose Y to differentiate between them. Okay, so two fundamental frequency, nu1 and nu2, when we are going to learn combination band. So two vibrational frequency, nu1 and nu2 in a molecule coupled to give rise to a new infrared active frequency. Means we are going to take nu1 and nu2 frequencies for two atoms and we are getting a new frequency, which should be the total sum of that. So So this band, new band, which will be observed, this band is sum of two interacting bands. Means sum means new one plus new two. If you make a sum, you will get some value that is new. So that new is known as new combination. Why? Because it is a sum. So combination band is the sum of two frequency. Whatever normal reading material we are reading, we are getting new one plus new two. But you have to make it very clear, if you are finding out new combination, it may also equal to, suppose I am taking this one as X and this one as Y. So it may be equal to X plus Y. It may also equal to 2X plus Y. It may also equal to X plus 2Y. What I'm going to tell you to clarify that the new combination band may be observed at this value. If it observed at this value, it may also known as combination. And if it observed at this value, because these are the sums. So that is about the combination band. This all thing shows the combination band. Next, difference band. So a new infrared active frequency arising due to the difference between the interacting bands means what? New difference equal to new one minus new two. That is called different band. In previous band we learned, or in combination band we learned about plus sum of the frequencies, while here in difference band we are going to learn that the difference between two frequency will be observed at particular value, and this will show us some specific value in our spectrum. So I would like to make very clear, new difference equal to mu one minus mu two. Suppose I am expecting this one as X, this one as Y. So now new difference may equal to X minus Y. This is one possibility. It may be known as new difference band. Another possibility, X minus 2Y. This may also called as new difference band. Another possibility, 2Y minus X. So these are the possibility for the different bands. So this is all about different band, which may observed in your IR spectrum. Last thing we have to learn in this video, that is Fermi resonance. So we should really make it very simple. When fundamental vibrations coupled, fundamental vibrations means what? New. Fundamental vibrations means new. When couples with an overtone or combination band. Overtone or combination band. See, overtone is what? I have to make it very clear here. Overtone is nu, 2 nu, 3 nu, etc. Combination band, just we learned nu 1 plus nu 2. Now, Fermi resonance is going to discuss what? When fundamental vibration nu couples with the either overtone or combination, means either this values or this value, sum of this value, if coupled with the fundamental vibration nu, means the coupling of this one and this one to this one. Okay, coupled vibration is called Fermi resonance. I hope it is very clear. Fundamental vibration is nu, it is in multiple, it is in sum. So if this value couple with this one, or it may couple with this one, combination of this one and this one, or the combination of this one and this one, is known as Fermi resonance. I hope now very clear to everyone. So Fermi resonance is observed normally, commonly it is observed in carbonyl compounds. So that is about the Fermi resonance. Thank you for listening. If you like this video, please like in YouTube and subscribe my channel. Thank you.